Welcome to Face It TV. I'm Daniel DDK Kapadia, and today we'll be looking at Group B play. We have, of course, seen Kick and NIP going through yesterday in Group A for the GSL Egamingbets Cup. And today we have Wizards, we have Frag, what is it again? Frag, Game Pub. I always confuse that. Game Pub, clan-mystik, and Xastana. They're going to be battling it out for a chance at that $2,000 prize purse, of which only 1,300 goes to the first place. So, kind of one of those prize pools where it's all about number one and the competition's going to be super fierce. We're going to look at Wizards and Xastana first of all, and Thorin is here to provide commentary with me. Thorin, what are your thoughts going into the first match? We've got the Spaniards Wizards.
Is it actually Wizards? Because on HLTV.org before it said that they'd been like replaced by HUD's G team or something.
It is Wizards. The other way around, it is Wizards. Okay.
Well, once I get in the server, I'll let you know. So now.
All right. Well, of course, Xastana, we're going to be seeing three best of ones in a row from them, as we saw three best of ones in a row from NIP yesterday. And everyone does like to see Xastana. They are always a big topic. I mean, we always talk about lineups, Thorin, you know, and with Xastana, they haven't disbanded yet because there was so much hype with all these like highly skilled players, maybe too many star players going into this lineup, but they're still sticking together. What are your thoughts on that? Do you think they need a new player, or is this the right course for them? Are
we going to see? I mean, if results? I had to guess, I'd say they're sticking together because the EMS Katowice is next week. So I think they're waiting to see what happens there. So for me, if they don't make top four, I'm pretty sure at least one player leaves, if not some kind of radical overhaul. Like, because the biggest problem with Xastana isn't even the failure of their lineup, which is the obvious like direct storyline. Like, they should have been so good. They seemed like they were going to be early on. It's that to form that team, they had to sort of ruin the Na'Vi team that was getting decent. They had to ruin the virtus.pro lineup that had beaten NIP. And then they made this team that wasn't that good. So if you split this team up, you could make two other good teams. Or maybe you take another play and you try to make this team again good. Like, I think this lineup will have run its course if they don't finish top four in EMS.
All right. So that's going to be quite interesting. It would be nice to see this as a success story because they've stuck with it for so long. But it looks like they are going to go into the knife round right now. It is going to be Nuke that these two teams will be playing. And Xastana, clan-mystik, I mean, those are the two obvious favorites for, you know, the top this group, wouldn't you say? We have Game Pub and Wizards.
Sure. I mean, the thing is, though, it's not like these two teams, Wizards and Game Pub, have no chance. Like, actually, Game Pub famously beat Xastana when they were Astana Dragons at the last Star Series and put them out. And so they went out in fourth place, which is like a huge shock because nobody even knew Game Pub offline. Like, they were only onliners. And so if they face them again, I'm sure the Game Pub people think they can beat them, and they're good online, so I'd assume that would be like a reasonably close match.
Yeah, that's going to be really interesting to see then. Of course, we will see that ASD versus Game Pub, that's going to be the second best of one coming up right after this. I hope we see three nukes again, because I'm actually loving Nuke. We saw three nukes yesterday, and it looks like we had the end of the knife round there, and we're seeing Xastana on the CT side. And the scoreboard's a little bit confused, but that's okay, we know what's up. And Wiz is going to be starting off as T. So right now it's not live, as you guys can probably see from the console text at the bottom left. But what kind of scoreline are we going to be looking at here, Thorin?
I mean, the problem is with Xastana, their biggest strength and weakness is the star players. And so if the star players go crazy, they can destroy a team like this. They could do like 16-3. Now, I don't actually think they're that good on Nuke, so I wouldn't expect something like that. I'd say more like a good range is probably for Xastana to win like 16-8. I'd say that as long as they come and they don't all fall flat, I'd say that's the sort of level I'd expect them to be at.
Right, okay. That seems fair. I'm really looking forward to seeing GamePub, actually, like you mentioned previously. They've done some crazy things in the past. They've got, you know, Macedonian and Bosnian in the mix with the Serbians, and it seems like a bit of a killer combo. So I'm hoping they're going to be able to perform today. And also, the thing is, it's actually kind of hard to call this in some senses because, I mean, we haven't seen how clan-mystik are just yet today. So, again, also looking forward to some KennyS action, as I'm sure many other people are as well, looking for some highlights, some, you know, frag material for Tweeday to work on when he's not doing his case openings. Are you a fan of Tweeday's case openings?
I don't give a fuck about cases, man. I do think that Kenny S is a really good player, though. But unfortunately, this isn't really the map where you want to make use of his skills. You know, something like Inferno, Dust 2, then he can go completely crazy on you. But it's a lot harder to be effective with the nuke on, with the AWP on nuke.
So where do you see the weakness? What maps are teams going to want to face Astana on, or Exastana rather?
I mean, nuke is one that I wouldn't mind facing them on because they didn't used to ever play it. And then they just started playing it around DreamHack Winter. So I still think it hasn't been proven as a strong map for them. I think Dust 2 is probably one that's you'd probably want to avoid versus them. Similar maybe for Inferno. I don't think they play Train particularly. And then Mirage, I think for all the teams, it's still really hard to call who's good on this Mirage because we haven't played it that much.
So actually just changing the topic slightly. Oh, actually, no, the players are getting ready, so we don't have to kill too much more time. But at some point, we should have a look at the IEM Katowice groups because that actually is really interesting to see what has happened there. And it looks like the players are jumping into the game. Here we go. This is going to be the first best of one today for Group B for the GSL Egamingbets Cup. And we have Wizards versus Exastana. Exastana starting off on the CT side of Nuke with Wizards on the Terrorist side. So here we go, jumping into this pistol. This is going to be pretty damn important for Wizards to grab this one. Let's see how they're going to attempt to do just that.
And when I was watching this Exastana team play in the online competition CS Forever, like last weekend, what they showed was on all the CT sides, they were really strong. They were just going off their individual skills. They'd play aggressively. But then on all the T sides, they did quite weakly. And that's why they lost to Fnatic, because they would play so passively on T side that then if the CTs played aggressively, they died. And so it seemed like what you'd expect from a team with a lot of star players. Like, they didn't have very good execution, or people weren't playing all the roles. They were just trying to look for their own shot.
And they do manage to catch Kucha there, who was trying to poke in for some information. They've been so quiet, and that's a nice pickoff from Angel as well. And it looks like the Wizards are going to just take that as the cue to rush into Rab, and a nice catch onto Angel. So they've gained the ground at Rab now. Adrian's readying himself to jump down the vents to try to catch some of the players from Wizards as Mason makes his way on the flank. He might just catch Dozier. He does. This is getting really bad all of a sudden for the Astana crew. As more of them fall, it's just Markolov left. And as we can see, he's only got 23 points of health. Not much hope for him here. So it looks to be that Wizards are going to take the first round in this game on Nuke. And that is a pretty important round for them to take, as that's going to at least guarantee them, hopefully, some more rounds here. But Markolov's going to go for it, it looks like. And they're all just hiding in every single corner they can find. There you go. You will finally go down. So hopefully Wizards aren't going to falter to any eco shenanigans coming in from Exastana. As we can see, a CZ 75 there, as well as a Deagle coming into play. A couple Deagles, in fact. So let's see how these are going to come into play. If they're going to be aggressive, or if they're just going to chill back, stack a site. Looks like Markolov's going to go outside in the garage for some long-range action with the Deagle. Might just
for
work
some
out.
Reason, I don't have like a gun model on my screen. Is that like a bug or something?
I think you need to press escape a couple times. That might fix it. Let's see, nothing outside for Exastana so far. Wizards playing it slow. I mean, it's the standard thing for the anti-eco. You want to try to just allow your opponents to walk into you if you can get some free frags. And, of course, avoid those close-range situations. I'm surprised they're not working outside, but you can see Exasana kind of counted on that. I think the Deagle investment was for that quick, you know, long-range shot or two. Even if you miss the head, a body shot is pretty damaging as well. But Markolov, after that opening, going to Yard, he backs away towards Rab. And still, we're just seeing one little trade. They managed to get a player picked off at Hut, and that's going to be the cue to go in on upper, and that's exactly what they do there. And right now, the bomb is going to go down. Wizards have this round in the bag. It's just Angel left. He's got a Deagle, but no hope to go with it. So 2-0 as expected.
Actually, one of the players who plays on Wizards here, Musambani, I'll give you a quick background on this guy. Okay, so in 1.6, really early on, in fact, actually before 1.6, it would have been around like 1.5 era. So I think it was around 2003. No one had ever heard of any team from Spain. And they had this tournament in France where a lot of the big teams went. And he went completely nuts. This one player and like established himself as like a really good player, even though he was from a country that in theory didn't have any good players. And for the next few years, he was like one of those standout players where like there's one really good player in that country, and then everyone watches that guy, and then his teams never do that well because they're not good enough. And so he was like the...
Seems like we lost Thorin there mid-sentence. So we'll try to get him back as quickly as possible as the Wizards do manage to catch Adren in the hut and gaining some ground on the outside as well. But let's see what Dozier can do here with this Deagle. Are you back, Thorin? Okay, no, he's off the call. All right, we'll get Thorin back momentarily. But Exostana in for some trouble here. Angel going for some pot shots with the Deagle. Won't find anything at all. Wizards playing together very well here, keeping it tight and under control as they move down towards the lower bomb site. And this should be a pretty easy affair, but Dozier and Angel with those Deagles, you never quite know what's gonna happen. But the odds are definitely against them. Smokes all over the place here on the site as the bomb does get planted by Zookatron. And there you go. Kills coming in to tidy up around right at the end. And they only lost two players, so that's not too horrendous. So they did very well on the anti-ecos. And you can see how much they respect Exostana, playing it very cautiously. I was, however, somewhat surprised they didn't really make many plays or much in the way of a committed play on the outside, as that's where you can really find a range advantage with those rifles. But looks like they're going to throw a couple players towards the outside now. And right now, Musan is trying to see if he can spot someone over secret. Not going to happen just yet. We can see the kind of setup here on the overview from Exostana. Got Adren in the CT main there. And the smokes, great coverage on the yard. Going to allow Wizards to go down the secret without much of a problem. And Kucha's not going to find much traffic over by the hut there. As Wizards now gaining more and more space, more map control, moving towards that lower bomb site. X is starting to know exactly what's going on. That flash for Adren, not going to get him the frag. That's going to be a big problem now, as they know exactly his position. Wizards now trying to take it slow with the Molotovs. Just holding the positions. Play it slow. Here they go, straight into the site. Going to take down Adren. But Dozius ready and waiting. Does take down Mason. Good stuff with the AWP. Wizards, they have to deal with this now. They used a lot of smokes. Do they have any grenades left to try to flush out the AWPer? Kutcher's going to be there on the catwalk there. Going to go down. And it's a two-on-two situation. Markloff over at the door is going to try to back his way onto carry, but he's gonna get taken down, and it's just Doja left with the AWP. If he wants a chance at this, he surely needs to pick up a rifle. It's gonna be very hard to deal with these riflers of Wizards, who are looking good now in this 2-on-1 situation. Dozier is gonna be thinking about that save, as we can see him backing away from the bomb. Maybe just catch an exit frag or so, but he is safe and sound with his AWP, and that is extremely important. Huge investment from the AWP. Don't get nearly as much money as you did in the old days from it either. So you really need to keep it alive for a few rounds for it to really start being cost effective. And at the very least, they do have that. You can see them buying Markloff in with the mag, got a Deagle on Angel. They're gonna keep the aggression high with this. So I'd love to see something interesting from Markloff with that mag. But the Wizards, they might be counting on an eco here. Let's see what they actually go with. They're just taking it slow again. And this seems to be working out for them so far. We've seen only one proper buy round from Exostana. And at that point, the slow play from Wizards, it worked out. It worked out in their favor. They were able to get the picks they needed to get the movement they needed outside. And now they're just holding. And this is always good to do as well. If you really don't know how a team is playing, you need to get the information first and never rely on let's say, a kind of prediction, or never rely on the metagame and just saying, oh, well, the metagame's like this, so we're going to go with this strategy. They're just getting the information first. Now they know. They're going for the push. They set up for it. Kucha going to go down upper site, well and truly under the control of the Spaniards now, as Dozier and Angel are the last ones remaining. And Dozier there with the AWP is just going to be in the same situation. No way to really retake this unless something ridiculous happens. And Wizards looking to take another round, moving it worse and worse for Exostana, who are going to be in a terrible situation economically now. As we can see, very little money for Exostana. Wizards doing a great job at the start of Nuke, and Terrorist side as well. And a bit of a peek there. Not going to go so well for Lowell. It's Angel happily takes off his head with the deagle. So there you go. Dozier does grab a frag, but it doesn't matter much as Wiz has got that bomb down. They want to hunt down the Exosana players, and Dozier does actually fall with that AWP. That's a massive loss for Exosana. What are they going to do in this next round? Let's check out the money situation. Of course, they're going to be in for a buy, so it's not too horrendous. But so far, it's 5-0, and if they cannot win this round, it's actually looking like Wizards might be closer and closer to setting themselves up for a big upset on Exostana. So checking out the overview here, you can see what Wizards go for again. We've seen the slow play from them thus far, and that's been really successful. So there's no real reason for them to mix it up too heavily. We can see that they have this habit to try to gain information before they fully commit to something. That's a very smart way to play, and if it is working out, then that is always good. So it seems like Thorin is actually back. They'll be joining us on the call very soon.
Right, mate.
Hello. Are you on the server as well?
I'm joining it now. My PC decided to turn itself off.
That's always a good one.
So it's Wizards sort of like, you know, one of those scenarios where Scotty and Star Trek can't get the Enterprise engine to go quite fast enough, and then, you know, he has to reboot it.
Of course. So actually, Thorin, you've missed some incredible rounds from Wizards. They're 5-0 up, and it looks like Lowell's trying to go on the clutch mode here. Oh, barely runs out of bullets in time. Can he make the frag happen for the 6-0? Looking for the shot onto Markloff, who's got the pistol. He knows he's really, really low. He's actually... Oh, and no, he cannot do it. Markloff finds the frag in the one-on-one, and that's going to be the first round for Exosana. That was incredibly important. Markloff had the AWP as well, and his team are just in financial shambles. That round is heavily important there, and Exosana can take a sigh of relief now as they move 5-1. And Wizards already, I mean, they're going to be feeling amazing with this. So let's have a look here. We have Exosana with a aggressive Angel moving outside. But again, Wizards, they love these defensive setups on Nuke. Just, you know, waiting for some information first. Let's see if we can work out exactly what's happening here with Angel as he's moving around. He might just come into contact very soon. We do have a lot of movement going on in lobby. Looks like they are posturing towards ramp. Here they come. Dozier's there for the defense. He's going to fall straight on back down into the lower bomb site. And Angel coming all the way around the back here. They may not be counting on this. Angel could be huge in this round for Exostana to secure it if this flank is successful. Still looks like they don't know, but look. Oh, great play from Musam. He does just catch Angel in the back, or in the front rather, as he approaches the back. And the movement goes down into the lower bomb site. And it's a 3-on-3. Markov still with that AWP there, but not much he can do from that position. The bomb is going to go down on the lower bomb site. Lowell there protecting the planter. It's all down to Adren, really, to make something happen. But the odds are against him. Here he goes, looking over towards that bomb. Going to go down, just Markloff, one-on-one against Musan with the AWP. This is a tough situation. Cannot miss the first shot. Just gets so bad for him if he does. He's going to go really close range. Here he goes, jumping straight on in. Pulls out the pistol, cannot do it. Musan again, great round from him. And Angel could have been a huge factor there, but losing that duel against Musam, who was in the ramp, preventing the flank. And that really, I think, was one of the reasons, or the ways from Wizards to really make that round go their way. So 6-1 now, Exostana going for the pistols. Things are looking terrible for them on Nuke. So did you manage to successfully connect to the server?
Yeah, I'm on now.
Okay, excellent. Wasn't quite sure. So thoughts on this scoreline so far?
I mean, somewhat surprising, because in theory, this team, Exostana, like to play Nuke a lot now. But like I said, they've only played it something like 10 times, so it's not like they've had a chance to really show they're like an amazing team on it yet. So I would have definitely thought they'd be leading on the CT half, but still a long way to go.
And it does look like Wizards, you know, four men still alive against the three pistols of Exosana, so this should be a pretty simple affair. But actually, Angel with this CZ-75, going to take down the bomb, so that's some good information for his team, but they don't really have anything to set up any kind of perimeter around there. So it looks like it should be another simple round, even though it's 3-3 at this point. Let's look at the positions from the players. Angel's going to be hiding in Toxic in case there comes a sly plant on the lower bomb site, which could be quite interesting to see if Angel can actually manage to make that frag happen. If we check the overview, we can see all this movement towards a ramp from the Wizards as they
toss the bomb. Actually have quite a good setup here because Kusha can go immediately down the vent. And meanwhile, Dossier has to wait to see if they come up or anyway. So now they should be down pretty quickly. Dossier will definitely be the last to go down now. That's just his style of play.
It looks like
so it'll actually be upper.
Yeah, they're going for the upper play. Straight out the hut with a quick entry frag onto Dossier. Bomb's going to go down. Kucha and Angel remaining for Exostana. And you can see they're both over at ramp. Not much for them to do over here. So looks like another round going to be going towards
the thing is,
Wizards.
If they go to the right place, there will be guns to pick up. So that's what they should be trying to focus on now. So you're going to see Kusha's going to look at zero weapon here.
So Angel is actually going to throw the flash in and go for the frag. Actually backs off. Here we go, backing off. It's pretty tough in this situation. There's no way he's going to get a defuse. And you know, like you were making the point yesterday, no point throwing the gun away. So he falls back to T-spawn. So he's going to keep his AK, and Angel does the same. Kusha does the same, rather. So two AKs in the mix, at least. That is quite useful. And can we see some rifles in onto Exostana as well on Markloff there. And some Famous is coming in as well. So they have some kind of a buy. It's not very, it's not the best buy in the world, but it is something. Exostana, they are really in troubling territory with this kind of a scoreline on the CT half. We've seen such strong nuke from them in the past. Already sided recently. So Wizards pulling out the results so far, but can they pull it all the way through to a victory? They're going to make the outside play. Lots of smokes going in across the yard, carpeting it. Nice little flash coming in, delaying them slightly from Dossier. Dossier going to spray through the smoke. Oh, that's such a shame. Dossier goes down. Lowell finds his head through the smoke with that bullet, and now they're making their ground again. And this has been quite successful for them so far. They know all the spots to check. Going to take down Angel as well. Mason, the first man in, through onto the window room now. Great position set up, but Markloff, he's going to try to do his best there. And he is holding them for some period of time, but it's going to be Kyrie with the flank who does take him out. And Kucha's left standing, one versus three. And the Wizards, once again, with this lower play, it's looking good, but Kucha's setting himself up for the clutch with the first frag. Smoke goes down for the plant, so Kucha knows the position of one player. Can he suss out the other one, though? I think he's got a good idea, just looking for the angles. He has some time in this one-on-two, but unfortunately for him, he's going to get found, and that's going to be that. So 8-1 now the score. What are you seeing from Exostana, really? That's, you know, why are they losing so many rounds here? What's the big weakness you're seeing, Thorin? Or is there one in particular, or is it just good play from Wizards? Oh, he dropped from the call again, so that's brilliant. I'm going to put it down to good play from Wizards. I mean, they've really been hitting all their smokes on the yard. I'm sure they've rehearsed it hundreds of times, but they're going for a fast upper rush now. First man through to the hut, getting the guy on CT main straight down and falling back. So this is really going to just throw out some confusion here. They're going to work out that it's pistols as well. So Exostana, they haven't done any, you know, over rotations or anything. They're just holding their positions. So that was a great little frag to make. Another pistol round coming in. Are we going to see a ridiculous result? Are Exostana going to even get on the board at this point? Only one round for them. And we're not far from ending the first half. So let's see what they have to do with these CZ-75s. Can they make it happen? Markloff tries to hold down CT main, but the movement is slow and considered from Wizards. They know that if one of them drops, one of their teammates will get the follow-up, will get the revenge kill. And that's how they're playing this, slowly using the outside advantage because the range is so strong for them with those rifles against the pistols. And I love how they're playing right now. It's so methodical, taking down Angel. It's as if the Exostana players cannot do anything against the Spaniards. Quite a surprising result so far. So just Markloff left. Let me check out the money situation. Yeah, I mean, they'll of course be able to buy after the eco. I mean, and having lost so many rounds in a row, they get the round loss bonus as well, but still such a hard spot for Exostana because it's not just that they have lost, you know, a few rounds. They've lost, they're 7 behind in the first half. It's just psychologically, it must be pretty tough to deal with. They're very experienced players, but when it just feels like you just cannot kill the opponents, even when there's not even like one player on your team that's at least winning rounds for you, that's clutching, you know, 1v4s or something to bring the kind of psychology, the momentum back to your team, it's really tough. So 9-1 now, and that is an insane result for the T side. Wizards just steamrolling Exostana. So here we have another buy, full buy here from Exostana. Let's see if they can do something with this. Got Markloff with that AWP, going to be making his way outside on that dog walk. Let's see what he can get with this. That Asimov. It's pretty awesome. So again, Wizards playing it slow, going to be looking for those picks. They are counting on Exostana making an aggressive play. That seems to be what they're counting on. And to be fair, they have seen those tendencies from Exostana. They've seen players like Angel, you know, creeping their way around the outside, trying to go for those flanks. And Angel is pushed up at T-Red. So can Mason actually work it out? He does turn for the frag, and Angel, even though he gets the initial shots, he cannot get the frag. Markloff does clean up and get the trade though, but still, they are making ground. They know his position. There goes the Molotov. Mason looking for that AWP. Adrian in CT main will drop Mason. So that's really good from Adrian to put the stop there. Does help massively, but now the upper site is compromised. The Wizards players flood in through the hut, and it is 2-on-2 with Markloff with that AWP. That's going to be tough. He needs to really swap that for a rifle. He needs some more speed, more pace to his play right now, as Wizards are all over the upper site. They're going to get the bomb down, and this is going to be a really tough position to use the AWP from. If they have correct positions, the Wizards players, they should be able to avoid any sticky situations from Markloff, or caused by Markloff rather, as Dozier pushes through. There goes the pop flash. In he goes, CT main. Great headshot from low. Beautiful shot. Markloff going down as well, and they fall like dominoes. Exostana just haven't the answer for the Spaniards. It is really impressive what we're seeing. Every time we're seeing the execution battles, the Wizards players are coming out more often than not on top. And that really seems to be the story. Also, it seems like they're playing their game. They're able to play their pace, and it's just working for them. It is just working. It's catching Exostana. And last round, you know, we saw that Angel, you know, he was the kind of floodgate. They got just burst open by Mason. And once he was down, they just hit Yard pretty hard, and it was really difficult. And they were syncing up on the Yard and on upper as well. And Exostana just collapsed to that play. And again, great pickoff from Mason on the outside. Exostana trying to defend this, but the smokes are pretty good from Wizards there. Looks like the bomber is actually hesitating, falling back a little bit. Might go back to lobby, but they just have control. It doesn't even matter at this point. Another great frag coming in onto Adren from Sukatron. And again, now they're just slowing the pace down. And this is really what has been working well for them. They play together. The pace is working so much in their favor. And now they're hitting it up hard again on the upper side. Going in fast. Oh, great play from Sukatron and Musam. Take control of the upper side. Just Angel left now. He's going to go down as well. 11-1, the score now. In this game on Nuke, this is quite a surprising result. And this is just, most people are going to say Exostana number one, clan-mystik number two for the Group B of the GSL Egamingbets Cup. And that would be what everyone would say. I'm fairly certain most people would say that. But right now we're seeing the Wizards, who may not have even been predicted necessarily in this group to do better than fourth place, perhaps taking what many would consider to take the first place. They are so close to this. 11-1 now. So the Wizards again taking it slow. Looks like they're setting up for some nades over into the upper bomb site from the garage. And in they go. Kucha gonna be spamming down with the FAMAS. Great play. He's gonna take down two players, but he's gonna need to do more than that. Exostana, they're 3-on-2. They finally have a man advantage, and the bomb is down. Dozier peeking in from the radio room. Spots the players over by the door. Does drop one. Lowell falls, and now only Musumban is left in the lobby all alone and with no one to help him. Nice position from Adrian. That's going to secure the round. And Exostana finally take a round. 2-11, though. Very, very tough stuff to deal with for Exostana. They're going to have a massive second half. And as we can see, money-wise, actually, Wizards aren't actually too well off. Not necessarily as well off as you would expect, but with so few rounds left, it doesn't actually matter, really, the economic situation for them. And again, seeing the kind of standard setup from Wizards. A couple guys outside. We've got a couple guys in lobby trying to protect against any push from Hutt. Kucha takes the risk. Doesn't get the frag onto Kyrie. So things once again slow down from Wizards. And being again a man down, they're going to just wait it out. From what we've seen, that just seems to be the trend for them. Lowell goes for the peak, and Dozier is going to respond in kind with a frag. 11-2 still. This is looking so bad. I can't stress that enough. But three men for Wizards. With three men, there's not many options you can really go for, and it seems to be that it has to be ramp for them. And this is something that Exostana should be able to deduce, but they seem a bit too scared to even peek into a lobby to get that information. And it looks like they've given up at least the upper area of ramp here as Wizards drop down slowly into the lower level. Exostana have yet to really get much information. They're playing so far back, even though there's five left alive. And here they go. They finally suss it out. They know what's happening. And Mason's going to take the frag onto Dozier. Trades coming in left and right, and Wizards are worse off for it. Musam's the last one. Exostana going to grab another round, making it 11-3. And we move into the last round of the first half. And of course, it is a must win for Exostana. They're already in an incredibly terrible spot. They've got to try to salvage this. It would be a fantastic comeback if they were able to do it. And their skill sets do work so well to play T side of Nuke. So would be really liking to see a fast pace in from them on the second half. The pre-smoke's going down to delay the pushes, delay the rushes here. Markov with a pre-nade. Trying to get lucky with that. Does a little bit of damage to three players. Dozier completely smoked off, and that's really the problem of holding yard on this map. But there's actually three players close to that yard behind that smoke, putting in the spam. Wizards are going to go down. Two players, three remaining. Musan with just 10 health left. And this should be a pretty simple affair now for Exostana. They got the information they need. They should be able to deduce more or less what's happening. And Kucha holding down the hut. And there's the bomb. Musan going to fall as well. So Exostana only have to worry about Lowell now. He's in a 1-on-4 situation, and he's going to get taken down. So there you go. First half score, 11-4. Exostana, a very interesting result for them so far. I mean, they can still turn it around, of course. They are a fantastic team. Highly criticized team, but a fantastic team nonetheless. And what can they do on the T side? We're going to have to see very, very strong execution. And they're going to have to use their strengths extremely well here to try to bring this back. Let's see what they go with here. Is it going to be ramp outside? How are they going to play this? Looks like we've got a couple of men going outside. Going to go for a bit of a split here. They've got three men towards ramp, actually. So kind of an even split, even spread across the width of the map. And Sukatron gets taken down. So a very, very fast opening here from Exostana Dragons. And oh, Musan Bani, how could you even predict someone's going to stand there? Going to get one player with that little ambush. And it's just Dozier left now after a very strong opening from Exostana. It's all on Dozier's shoulders. And he has to win this pistol round. They need every single round at this point. The implications, if they lose this, it is life or death in this tournament. So Dozier going to fall back finally with the bomb. This is such a hard spot. Going to go for the fastest plant he possibly can, straight in the middle of the room and fall back through the door. Can he do this? He's got the Glock. He's got quite a bit of health and Kevlar left, so he should be at least good for a duel. Here he goes, waiting for this sound cue. He's going to jump into the vents. If Wizards play this correctly, then it should be almost impossible for Dozier unless he completely out-executes them. Here he goes, spamming down onto Kyrie. He does manage to grab the kill and the second one on the diffuser. Well played from Dozier. Huge round, such an important clutch for Exostana to keep them alive in this game. Now they can at least have a chance. They can at least have a chance. Adrian picking up, I think, the MAC-10 SMG and Galil, couple AKs, couple of Galils in the mix. And would expect some kind of outside play from them. We do have quite a bit of movement onto the outside, but it seems to be an even split once again, actually. So the movement coming in outside. And we can see a stack coming in from the Wizards here. Look at them all outside, boosted up there. And Dozier is going to just pretend it's a shooting gallery. Kyrie coming in from behind with a 5-7. Beautiful timing there, actually. The distraction worked out perfectly. And then Dren coming in from the ramp, going to spray down Sugatron. But here we go. Kyrie is just coming alive in this round. And 3-on-3 is the situation we find ourselves in. 2-on-3 now. But Kyrie has the AK. What can he do with this? Looking for that headshot. And Markloff is going to silence him. Big round from Kyrie there. Almost resulted in very upsetting news for Exostana. But Musam at least is going to save the AK. And that is, you know, that's a result for them. They have a lot of rounds to play with, a big round buffer. So they can even get really risky. I mean, when you have a big, big lead, you can do incredible things with it because you can afford to lose a few rounds here or there. As long as you don't lose rounds at points which are really going to screw over your economy or have terrible implications that way, then you can do whatever you want, really, to try to throw off the other team who are going to be playing in a more conservative fashion, a more safe fashion, because they know that the margin for error is nothing. They cannot drop a single round. So 11-6. We can see the money situation then. Also got Lowell topping the scoreboard for Wizards. We've seen some amazing stuff from him. And Dozier and Adren top fragging for Exostana at the moment. As we see Exostana moving their way through outside. And it's a rush without any kind of smokes because they know they're going to be against the pistols. And Musam goes down, Kyrie's going to have that AK. And outside is controlled well and truly by Exostana. So here goes the boost up to heaven. And Angel coming in with the frag onto Kyrie. So Kyrie, he's been really huge for Wizards as well as Lowell. Made some great plays. And Exostana just taking their time with all the map control that they have. See Angel just searching here. And there you go, there is Meissen gonna get taken down by Angel as Lowell goes through in the confusion, manages to find a kill, and Dozier does get the return for the round. 11-7, things looking better so far, but of course we're gonna have the buy coming in for Wizards. So this is their chance to put their foot down and just say no to Exostana Dragons, who want to come back in this best of one game. So again, if you're just joining us, this is Group B play. It's the first best of one today between Exostana and Wizards. The next match coming up is going to be Exostana versus GamePub. With three Serbians, Macedonian, and a Bosnian in there. Lovely mix. And GamePub definitely a very interesting lineup with some interesting results in the past. So it's hard to really predict what they're capable of. So again, slow play coming in. Exostana don't want to give anything away. Just trying to find those picks, wait for those smokes to dissipate. It's really one of the difficult things about how good the smokes are in this game. You throw a smoke down and running through it is somewhat suicidal. Here you go. We saw some amazing play from Freiburg yesterday in this position that Musam is in against T players playing the door spot, just dropping down at the right angle to catch them off guard. You see still the very slow setup. So let's just check the overview now. We can see the spread. We can see Angel moving his way on the outside, does manage to catch a kill onto Sukatron. So now Wizards are going to be thinking about this guy who could possibly flank them. This guy is adding a lot of pressure, and they're just going to go now into the upper bomb site. Musam takes down one, but that's not going to be enough as Adren is going to plant the bomb. Markloff and Dozier are left to cover him. But here comes Kyrie through the heart, looking into Markloff, does take him out, gets the headshot onto Adrian as well, looking for the third, but Dozier closes him down. And it was so close from Kyrie. He knew exactly what he had to do, but just couldn't quite come close enough. So 8-11 now, Astana with the climb, climbing the colossal mountain that Wizards have created for X Astana in that first half. But we know X Astana is a great team for execution, great team for aggression. What was so uncharacteristic on the first half was just seeing them like losing so many duels, so many execution battles, which usually you would see that go their way, went the way of the Spaniards. So again, let's just see how things are going. Here comes the peek onto Kyrie. Dozier does take him down. So again, added pressure losing a player early in the round, but of course they are with pistols, so it's not a big deal really. Not a big deal at all. I was actually surprised, I gotta say, that we didn't see anything, any interesting setups. It was the standard setup of the pistols. They didn't really take, for example, a stack on the site or a rush anywhere. Perhaps a lot of respect for Astana's ability to cope with that. Because again, they have, perhaps they don't feel like they can throw rounds away at this point, because Astana have built up a lot of momentum. And we're starting to see that execution really coming in from Astana as well. So here we go. Waiting for Musam and Lowell to show themselves. They don't want to do it. They don't want to do it. And if some of you are wondering where Thorin went, well, I'm wondering the same. Thorin just disappeared. It seems like his computer is having a lot of issues, so we'll have to grab another co-caster in the break after this. Unfortunate, as Thorin always provides such great insights into the matches that we see. So 11-9 now the score between these two teams, and again, we're seeing a very decent money situation building for X Astana. So they're starting to feel really comfortable, and the Wizards aren't quite doing the job they need to on the CT side. They have their buy round, Sukatron with that AWP, and right now it seems as if he's going to try to operate from the window. It's a great spot for it. He can take a couple shots, fall back, and be pretty safe. But here we go. They're going to push their way into upper, taking down Lowell on a catwalk. And now problems for Wizards as they lose that key player in the upper bomb site. And X Astana have a lot of time to work with. And we can see that they might try and just wait to see if there's going to be any rotation here. They've got a man covering it. And Markov slowly edging his way in, relaying the information to his teammates. Soon the grenades are going to come and it's going to be go time. Here we go, up through the vents though. It's going to be Musan with two crucial kills onto Markov and Angel, shutting down the upper aggression, moving it to a 2-on-4 now in the favor of Wizards. Kucha though, trying to even up the situation, taking down Musan through the door. Dozier with that AWP. Not a huge amount of good right now in this position, but here we go. Kucha's going to face through the heart. Mason going to take him down, and Doze is probably thinking about the save here, but can he find a kill? He's waiting for a greedy Spanish guy to come edging that door so he can shoot him with that AWP, but they are controlled. They are very considered and calm at the moment. They know they don't need to push. They have the bomb under control. Round time is going to end, and Dozier has successfully saved his AWP, which is quite crucial. But his team has so much money, it's really no problem to lose a round or two at this point, at least on the money standpoint, as we can see there. But things are getting close. We're getting close to the end of the second half. So 12-9 now. 12-9. Just check out the movement from teams here. Sukatron, the lone man outside. You can see aggressive positioning from X Astana, at least initially, trying to see if they can, you know, capitalize on the timing there. And here they go straight into the bombsite. And the grenades are going off left and right. And Mason, with a key defense, taking down two players out of hut. And now the rush has kind of been halted completely, and Wizards take control of this defense, but Markloff trying to equalize desperately. does manage to grab Lowell. And here, Sucatron going to try to peek outside as Dozier, with his teammates, make the effort on Rap, hoping that it's clear. Hoping that Wizards kind of rotated out of that after the upper rush. And it seems to be the case. But it looks like they're going to push through to the ladder room. Oh, and Sucatron was waiting for it. They'd worked it out. Angel gets the trade, though. Up the ladder he goes. They know he's there, looking at the angle. It is suicide. Markloff left with 12 health. Not a good position to be in. As he edges again the door, but they must know that he's coming from this position. They're going to gun him down. And there you go. 13-9. Wizards going to start taking control of the game once again. And Exostana is looking pretty bad. Six rounds for them to win, and just two, or three rather, for Wizards. So you can see the money there. It's going to be tough for Exostana if they lose the next one. I mean, they're going to have no way to really bind us to get a plant. Maybe they can get a drop or two, but that's about it, really. And there go the pre-nades coming in from Sucatron. See, Dozier is with the AWP. He could really open this round up right now, but Wizards are playing incredibly defensively outside. And because of this, it's going to allow them to really prevent anything terrible from happening, any kind of one of those chaotic situations from happening. They're just staying tied together, defensive setup, and working off the information they get. We can see that Exostana moving closer into the yard at the moment. So really liking this from Exostana at the moment. This boost onto T-Red. But Wizards, they aren't really playing for frags. They're playing for the upper site, and you know, they're playing for the ramp and the vents. And they are happy to give away the outside positioning. Oh, and Sucatron goes down to the AWP of Dozier. Great jump from Kusha. Sacrifices his life so his teammate can take down the AWP player, and they're going to gain control of the outside. But I think somehow Wizards are okay with that, as you can give away outside, and you can play a strong defense just holding upper and using those vents. You can get so fast down to lower site. But here goes Adrian up the ladder, and there's fire all over the place to greet him. As it looks like they're going to make their way through CT main right now. There go the grenades. There goes the frags. Wizards locking it down. Just Angel left. Got the deagle there. Going for the shots. Does manage to take down Kyrie. Problem is, no armor. No health left. And if he dies after time, oh, Angel's not going to get any money. Terrible situation. Just two more rounds for Wizards. They've got to be feeling ecstatic right now. This would be quite an upset if Exostana lose against them. 14-9, unbelievable stuff here on the first best of one of today for the Group B play. Just mixing stuff up like crazy, shaking it all up. The Wizards have the moves for sure. Have a good overview there of what's actually going on with the movement of the players. And so far, the upper defense has just been incredibly strong. We haven't seen many lower plays onto the lower side from Exostana, and they haven't really tested the players on ramp that much either from Wizards. They do commit a lot to these outside and upper plays, and so far the Wizards just so good at defending. Sucatron against, again, very defensive positioning, but he gets the kill. Kusha edging onto him, catches the head of Sucatron with his AK to get the frag, and Kusha going in for the second frag, going to at least force the player back, giving control of the outside again to Exostana. But last time, they weren't quite able to use it very well. This time has to be different. It just has to be different for them. 4-4. And Angel is just loving how much space they have at the moment. I mean, the thing is that deduction works on what you see, but also what you don't see. And by not seeing players in certain positions, it's going to help them really deduce exactly where the defense is set up for Wizards here. Markov checking the angles. There he's going to find Kyrie. Does take him down. 3-4 at the moment. 2-3 now as the kills come flying in. The bomb does go down though. Good result there for Exostana, who need all the money they can get. 2-1. All on Musam right now, who's in the vents to take this down for Wizards to stop this plant situation. Gets the first frag. 1-1. 9 health. Cannot do it. Markov is ready. And it's so hard when they already know your position. Especially when you're that low. So Exostana, by the skin of their teeth, they're going to be holding on here. But still just two rounds for Wizards, and we can see that they're throwing three Famouses in there and getting that AWP onto Sucatron. So if they lose this, they can't actually buy. So this round is absolutely massive for Exostana. It could be the round which really brings them back into the game, as it shouldn't be too difficult to cope with pistols if they win this. It shouldn't be too difficult, at least. But you never know. So both teams, respecting each other a lot. They both know that this is such a critical round at the moment. It's playing it pretty slow. You can see just making some noise over in lobby whilst they push outside. We've got a player on top of CT main at the moment. Likely to drop down very soon and make that aggression. But Sucatron, I think he's going to be ready for this. He's got the AWP, spots some pixels, does catch the head of Kucha, swipes it clean off with the AWP. Adren trying to make his frag over at the ramp. And it looks like Exostana have control of the outside, but they lost the man to do it. And here goes Angel. Brilliant play from Angel going through the window. And now they know where he is. Musaim gets dropped. And that's not even enough. Sucatron going to go down to Angel as well. Now, as he moves up the ladder, Angel is making this round for Exostana. 3-on-4. Two Famouses and an M4A4. It's not a lot to work with. It's going to have to do, though. There comes in a team kill. Angel going to kill Lowell, though. So things are calming down a little bit, but it's a one-on-one situation now. And if Kairi makes this happen, it could very well allow them to win the game. And boom, he manages to hit the head of Angel with the FAMAS. 15-10 now. And again, look at this money. Look at this money. This is so bad for Exostana. They got to buy. They just have to buy. They cannot do anything else. They lose this round. It's all over for them. 15 rounds to the 10. Wizards are one away from an upset against Exostana here. It would be quite an incredible result. I know they're going to be feeling ecstatic if they do it. But let's see exactly what happens. They have even an oomp coming in from Markloff. Let's have a look at the positions here. They're holding out lobby. The pre-smoke there. You can see two players for Exostana moving outside down secret. And this could be where they make it happen with this movement down secret. Adren, trying to catch any rotation through radio, and whilst his teammates make a more concerted effort towards the lower bomb site. Angel going to get taken down, though, as Adren holds this angle tight. Here they go. Wizards know what's up. They have a good setup to defend this. It's all down to execution now and good communication. So here goes Exostana's very last chance to stay in this game with the pistols, with the oomp. And it looks as if it's a 3-on-3 now, as the Wizards lose yet another man. But there is the trade there. It's a 2-on-2. They know what's happening. Here they go. Markloff moves in to the lower bomb site with Kucha. They got stuff under control here. Markloff, he really needs to plant that bomb though. Only 20 seconds left. Here he goes for the plant. The plant is heard. And Sucatron and Lil move closer. In goes Markloff to Toxic. And he's the last man standing. Did they see him go there, though? Looks like they don't know. But can they react in time? Here goes Markloff. Cannot do it. That's going to be the game for Wizards. They're going to actually defeat Exostana Dragons. 16-10 on Nuke. Big result for the Spaniards. Big, big result. I am pretty impressed by them. So guys, we'll go to a quick break. Remember, in the break, that's a chance for you to check out the platform, check out the pug system and the tournament system as well. You can win points on the Faceit platform, redeem them for awesome gaming goodie prizes, and also check out the Overwolf app. And we're going to go to that break. We'll have GamePub versus Exostana coming up next. Can GamePub do the same? We shall.